First of all, I'd like to thank Mike and Dave for sponsoring and having this venue. It's good. They're great advocates for our business, and we need people like that, and you do a great job for us. You know, in this day and age, identity theft is a big problem. And about 3 months ago, my wife's credit card got stolen. I thought, this is going to be a headache. But then I started getting the bills, and I didn't turn it in because the guy was spending less than she was. My name's Mark Foster, and I grew up on a farm on the Indiana-Illinois border. We farmed. We had livestock. We worked all the time. My buddies were out running around on weekends. We were working. I wanted to get away from agriculture so fast, I decided to go to college, and I was a school teacher. Really, I was a basketball coach. And, you know, I did that for a few years knowing that the Lakers would call someday and want me to be part of their staff. Didn't happen. And as I stayed in teaching and coaching, 15, 16, 17-year-old kids running around there with your livelihood in their hands was not the best thing. So I got out. I went to work for a NASA harvester. I was a territory manager for 5 years, was calling on the Berkey Group. They purchased a store in Indiana where I was from, the Williamsport area. I became a partner in 83, ran that store. We were in the car business. I ran that. I run our Hoopson store. I was sales manager. I have been ag division manager. We're going to change our structure a little bit. I'm going to be a regional manager going forward where we're going to divide up the locations a little bit differently. So, you know, our company started in the 50s. And when you look at the history of our company, in those almost 60 years, we have only had three people that have actually led our company. Floyd Berkey and his brother started the company in like 1954. And he was president and CEO up until the 70s. At that time, Gary Hedge took over, and he was president and CEO up until the 90s. Ron Berkey took over in 1990 or so and led the company until just 2012. And now Mike Hedge, who is going to be president and CEO, took over January 1st. So I'm going to talk a little bit about succession planning of the leadership of the organization. You know, in the history of our company, we've only had three people be president CEO, now four. And, you know, we did this past year, started a process of determining how we determine who is going to be the next president CEO. So, you know, what I'm going to talk about is, you know, the process. When do you begin the process? Outline the process. Talk about the buy-in from the partners, the decision, and who and when to notify the transition. You know, when you be in the process, obviously early is better than later. We have kind of asked for 2 years, not only from people that are going to retire as president CEO, but owners in general. All of our owners have always been active in the business. And we've always had a lot of owners, as many as 12. No one's ever had controlling interest. Today, there are six of us that own the business. And Ron, as he retired, he is still going to be an owner and is the first person that has been an owner and not actively involved in the business. So we've asked for 2 years. Just a small note, in the 58 years we've been in business, we have never had an owner pass away, and obviously we have never had a CEO pass away while they were an owner. So that's a little bit different. But I would tell you that if you're going to do this process in a group like ours, you cannot overemphasize planning. It's very important. You know, then we sat down and outlined the process, and that is a very critical step. You want to make sure everybody has their voice heard. Let everybody have their 2 cents, how they think it ought to go. And at the same time, we decided to let everyone that wanted to be considered for this role to be considered. But once that's determined, once you determine the process of how we're going to select our new president CEO, you lay it out in black and white. Historically, they've always been kind of anointed. Floyd started the company with his brothers. Gary Hedge was kind of the next obvious choice to lead the company. Ron Berkey, who's Floyd's son, was the next obvious choice. And then we came when Ron retired. It wasn't quite that way. We didn't really have someone that was really anointed to be president and CEO of our company. But just as important as outlining the process is to get that buy-in from the partners. You know, once it's determined how we're going to do this, everyone needs to sign off. I've said this many times, not only in this type of role, but any type of role. If you're big enough to put your name on the line to win, you have to be man enough to put your name on the line to understand you may not win that position. And in our company, we have never been one that has had a lot of high positions, a lot of high level of hierarchy, so to speak. We've been kind of lean and mean. All the owners, up until Ron, have been active in the business, either running a store, CFO, run a parts and service division, whatever. But we've always felt like that really we just need one person doing that job. So, you know, again, you know, it's a kind of a process that can be trying at times. This past year, Ron and I served as what we'd call transition committee. I was chairman of that committee, and we went through the decision. You know, we made sure that all interested parties had their day. We outlined the job description, which we had one previously, listed some questions, gave everyone an opportunity to tell how they see the company moving forward in the future, and how they felt like they would, what they would bring to that role. Very important to keep an open mind, but you know, ultimately the decision lies with the board of directors. You know, we made our recommendation. We felt like that this was the best course of action for the company and the shareholders, but that's only a recommendation. The board had to decide who was going to be the next president and the next CEO. So that final decision always lies with the with the board, and it's what's the best interest of the company and the shareholders. So you go through all this, you do the planning, you outline the process, you get everybody to sign off, you make a decision, what's next? Well, in this day and age, you know, there's a lot of ways to get that information out. What we decided to do was we felt like a 6-month period was a good time to make that transition. You know, that gave Ron time to clear his plate, you know, get things that he had on his schedule to do, get them finished, get them completed. It gave Mike an opportunity, who was our CFO, to clear his plate and get somebody to backfill his position. And really and truthfully, that process, instead of being 6 months, was more like 4 to 5 months. And then as Ron started to back away, Mike started to take over. We decided that we would start with our major supplier, and what we did was we're case dealers. We got in the car. I didn't get in the car, but Mike and Ron got in the car, drove to Racine, sat down with the North American operation people, and outlined our plan and asked for their blessing. Fortunately, they gave it. You know, so we did that. Then we moved on to other suppliers, employees, customers, lenders, etc., and tried to do that as close to possible to all at the same time. Didn't happen that way, but you know, we got the information out to the rest of the people in a timely fashion. And you know, you should always anticipate surprises. Where will they come from? It varies. You know, sometimes company people, sometimes employees, sometimes you know, lenders. They ask, you know, why did you do this? How did you go this way? And the answer has always been, we felt like it was the best course of action to lead our company into the future. So, you know, with that, I will answer any questions later on. I don't have any more jokes, so that's all that I can do. But again, thanks for having us here and participating, and hopefully it was informative to you. Thank you.